Tonight, investigative reporter Chad Pradelli has a provocative look at bus safety on SEPTA. And what he found is that if statistics serve as a guide, SEPTA buses get into a whole lot more accidents than public transit in some other cities. The question is why. Here is Chad's report.
It was turning so fast and so sharp that I could not get out of the way.
Haley Freilich was crossing Broad Street at Vine. You see her walking along the side of SEPTA bus 8310. The traffic signal shows pedestrian crossing, yet the bus driver makes a hard right, striking Freilich.
I remember just being on, I didn't know the extent of my injury at that time. I just knew that it was really painful.
On that life-changing day in October of 2017, Freilich remembers an EMT nurse treating her on the cold pavement. People gathered. She was rushed into Hahnemann Hospital just a few steps away, where doctors amputated half of her foot.
Your mind starts to spiral as to how much it will affect your life.
The accident is one of more than 14,000 SEPTA bus accidents from 2016 through 2019. An alarming number that raises questions about the safety of SEPTA buses and its drivers.
When you hear that number, it's tough for some to believe that SEPTA drivers are being as safe as they should be.
14,000 sounds like a high number, but when you put it in the context of the 45 million miles that we travel, I think we run a safe operation.
Assistant General Manager Scott Sauer is in charge of bus operations at SEPTA. He's also a former bus driver. He says the majority of the accidents are minor in nature.
Driving through these streets is a very challenging proposition for a bus operator driving a large vehicle down streets that, quite frankly, were designed in the 1780s.
Under right-to-know laws, Action News requested 4 years worth of bus accident reports for SEPTA, as well as similar bus transportation agencies in Chicago and Houston. A deep dive into the data and Federal Transportation Administration reports found SEPTA has a bus accident for roughly every 100,000 miles driven. Metro Public Transit in Houston, an accident for a little more than 1 million miles driven. And Chicago Transit experiences an accident for roughly every 2 million miles driven. So a passenger on SEPTA is more than 20 times more likely to be involved in an accident than in Chicago.
Are you surprised by that discrepancy?
I am surprised by the discrepancy, and I can't explain why Chicago's numbers are so low.
It is a horrible, sad, terrible tragedy that never should have happened, but for the reckless misconduct once again of SEPTA.
High-profile civil attorney Tom Kline is representing Freilich. He says damage caps in the Commonwealth, currently $250,000 per victim, have allowed SEPTA to recklessly operate with little consequence. Many states like Illinois have no caps on liability involving state vehicles driven by state employees.
How can it possibly be fair, possibly be right, for the damages in this case to be limited to $250,000?
SEPTA couldn't comment on Freilich's accident. The bus driver, though, was fired. Freilich now wears the prosthetic. Her favorite passions, running and dancing, are no longer an option. She hopes her story will improve SEPTA's safety record on the roads.
It's something that I know I'm going to have to deal with at this point, literally the rest of my life.
Would it be fair to say you have work to do?
I wholeheartedly agree that there's always work to do.
We have a more in-depth investigation into SEPTA, including the most dangerous bus routes. You can catch that on our 6 ABC streaming apps. I'm Action News investigative reporter Chad Pradelli, Channel 6 Action News.